Hey friends, if you love photography and like to sell your photos and videos online, make sure you subscribe, hit the bell icon and turn on all the notifications so that you never miss any video guides from the Teaching Dog channel. And here I come. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the channel. This is Dr. Arindam and you are watching the Teaching Dog. For those guys who have subscribed to my channel, I thank you so much. It's your support that motivates me to upload weekly videos. And for the new guys, hi, I am Dr. Arindam. I'm a medical doctor by profession and a photographer by passion. And in this channel, I have been posting a lot of video guides, how to sell your images and videos as stock photography and earn some money from your passive income. So make sure you follow me so that you don't miss anything in future. Now, this is the part 2 of the advanced stock photography series which I started last week, how to be 10 times more efficient in uploading your stock photos to various agencies. Now, the basic requirements on how to follow this method efficiently I have told in my last video, so make sure you first see that video and then come back to this. I'll give the link of the video in the card above or in the description. So if you really want to be good in stock photography, be honest to you, pause this video, go back there and then come back. So now that you have seen the video, and for those who already seen the video, you already know by now, you need to upload similar categories of photo in one go. You need to shoot the same subject from different angles, and it's very important that you assign the same title, description and keyword to each and every one of them. Well, last week we discussed about Shutterstock, and in this video I'll be taking up another three agencies: iStock, Dreamstime and Adobe Stock. These are the most important agencies after Shutterstock as per my earnings. So I will take them in this video, and the rest of those agencies I will cover in my part 3 video. Now you know the basic concept is same in every agency, but each and every agency differs a bit in the upload process. So I will straightway go into my computer and I will show you each and every agency and how to get the job done. Alright, so now as you saw last week, I am browsing through my folder where I have a lot of images, but I will choose only those images which are very similar. So this week we will be choosing 4 images of Mughlai Paratha. That's an Indian dish available on roadside, alright, fried Indian food. So basically these will be the 4 images that we are planning to upload. And as you saw last week, I already edited these images a bit so that they are high in saturation and gives a bit punchy look. So after editing them, the next thing what we did was we assigned them same title and keyword via XPix. We need to make sure the keywords, titles and the names and description are absolutely same. Then we need to upload to all the websites in one click. See, there are tutorials on XPix and everything. Every one of these features are explained in my previous videos. Please check the links in description or check my YouTube playlist. Alright, so now we will click upload, and once we are done, previously we showed Shutterstock. Now this week, this is iStock. Alright, in iStock, as you are doing the upload, you need to name a project and you need to click on new submission. In the creative image section, there is an iStock guide how you reach this place. There is a guide, alright, please check that. Today we are not showing you the basic upload. Today you are showing how you can become the most efficient. So you have to know the basic uploads before knowing this video. So we'll be just browsing and entering these 4 images and give iStock some time so that these images are uploaded. You know, I don't upload iStock through XPix, I upload them manually. So let's check some other websites in the meantime. See, Dreamstime, XPix already uploaded them into Dreamstime. In Dreamstime, there is no way you can select all the images and do all the stuffs at once. So see, very important, we need to click commercial. The first image, you need to do all the things manually. In Dreamstime, you need to give a different title and description. Alright, so I will just add a full stop. I'll just add a full stop. You see, it says you are unique. Try to give a unique title, don't copy others. Alright, after giving, just adding a full stop, title will be different. Then we'll be selecting some category manually. Of course, it's industries, food and beverage. This is food and beverage, and also there's another category for food, which is food ingredients. All right and optionally, in the third panel, you can use home related objects because these are cooking utensils. So once you are done with all the 3, be very careful.
you need to click submit. Alright, so this is one image which is done manually. Now what you need to do is you need to click on auto populate for the next images. Alright, and simply you need to select the previous image and drag all info, click on all info and just click populate. Alright, if you do this and if your previous images title description is same, you can simply click on auto populate, everything is done, submit. So just you need to make few more clicks, same thing, auto populate, click populate images, and then you are done. Alright, I'll just repeat the same thing for all the images. You can see it's so easy. Nothing, you don't need to think anything. If your images have same title description keywords, simply click on auto populate. Alright, if your title and titles are different, the categories are same, you can import categories, even you can import the same model releases, but the process is same. You need to use the auto populate feature. Alright, so now you see images on Dreamstime are done. So as I told you, our third and last will be Adobe Stock. In Adobe Stock, you need to click on uploaded files. When you click on uploaded files, you will see all the four files have already been uploaded by Xpix. Since it's same, all the images are same, you need to simply click select all category. Today's category will be food. You need to make sure you click on the paste keywords and no recognized property. Alright, just these are ready. Just simply click submit and you are done. So now you see it's so easy. If your images have got the same category in Adobe Stock, right? Had the images been different, you had to select each and every images, assign them categories, and it would have taken way long time. Alright, it's not efficient. So this is how you can do it in Adobe Stock. So now we are back to iStock finally, and you see all the images have been uploaded, right? Now one important thing in iStock is to note that the images, the title of the images are blank. Alright, you can see on the right side the description is automatically detected but not the title. Xpix title is not detected in iStock. This is the reason I told you to keep the same title for all the images. Alright, even if it's not important for other agencies, because in iStock you need to copy the text from the description and paste into the title for each and every images. But if all of them have got the same title, you need to just simply copy the description and then select all and paste the same text in the title. That way you are done assigning title to all the images. Alright, next you need to select the zone, country which is India, and then simply need to click on save and then submit. Alright, this is the most efficient way. If each and every image is different, you need to click on description, copy and paste the title separately. So this is the best way you can upload so many images on iStock.
This is the most efficient way how you can upload in all those agencies in just few clicks. I hope you are watching this video till now. Time to prove that by adding the code of the day in the comment. Well, code of the day is multi. Please type multi in the comment section so that I'll be able to know that you are watching this video till now. Well, if you have not yet started stock photography and if you are waiting to start stock photography, then please make sure you check my links in the video description. There are referral links which will help you to sign up and starting your stock photography journey. Please hit the thumbs up if you have liked this video. This will help my channel a lot. And please share this video with all of your friends and cousins who love stock photography, because as I always tell you, my motive here is to bring up a strong community of stock photographers. Well, the series is not over yet. As you know, I upload in a lot of more agencies and I'll be taking all of them together in my next video. But this is it for today's video. This is Dr. Arindam. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.